Hello again. This is the first lesson of a crash course on how to create your own cryptocurrency. Here we're going to show you step by step how to launch your token. And no, you don't need to be a cool programmer or read tons of articles about blockchain to do this. All you need is a little bit of diligence and follow this course carefully. Are you ready? Then here we go. The first thing you will need is the source code. This is the code for the standard ERC-20 token that we will be using during the crash course. And most importantly, we have made it free for everyone. Download it on our website or from the CryptoKoki GitHub repository. We already talked about this in our last video, the hint will be in the corner. In addition to the source code, you get a crash course outline in PDF. All links will be in the description. Now let's get to the lesson. And the first thing we will get acquainted with is Remix ID. This is where your token will be created and managed. You can get here by following this web address. All useful links, as always, will be in the description. And here it is, the Remix workspace. Let's see what is what. First of all, the main menu. This is where you switch between the main toolbars needed for deployment and contract management. Here is the workspace of each of the menu items. This is where you will spend the most time. Right now, we are in the file manager for managing our project files. Next is the code editor. This is where the smart contract code is written and edited. But right now, this is just the home tab. You can close it. And below that is the console. The console displays all transactions launched from Remix ID. This is very important to understand which transactions were successful and which failed. Now, I will close home tab and create a new file. You can give it any name you want, but I will name it token. It will contain a token smart contract for deployment. Now I will put the source code of the Starter ERC-20 token in this file. As a reminder, you can get it completely for free from our website or GitHub. Links in the description. Now you need to set the basic properties of the token. They are also called metadata. They include contract name, token symbol, its decimal, and total supply. Let's break them down in order. Contract name is the name of the smart contract that will only appear on the blockchain scanner. As an example, I will name it after this channel, CryptoKoki Contract. Token name and its symbol are exactly the name and abbreviation of your token which will represent it and which will be remembered by investors. I will also name it after the channel, CryptoKoki and symbol, Koki. Decimal determines the number of decimal places in your token. The default value is 18, but also there are three generally accepted options, 18, 9, 6, and 3, but we will leave the default value. Total supply is the number of tokens that will be issued with token deployment. Let's specify the amount of 150 million tokens. Great, now that we have specified the token metadata, we can start compiling. For this, we go to the corresponding menu item. Here we are offered to choose the compiler version. To find out the version we need, let's go to the beginning of the smart contract. And here we see version 0.8.19. We choose it from the drop-down list, then click Compile. If there are errors or warnings in the contract, they will be displayed below. Now an important step that will be useful for those who deploy token in the Ethereum network is to optimize the smart contract. It allows you to reduce the cost of token deployment and it will allow you not to go bankrupt due to high gas price. To do this, you need to open the Advanced Configurations tab and check the Enable Optimization checkbox. After that, compile the smart contract again. And now it is optimized. Next, let's move on to deploying the token. This is the part in which it will appear in the blockchain. To do this, go to the next menu item, Deployment and Run Transactions. Now, you need to connect your MetaMask to the Remix ID. To do this, select MetaMask from the Environment drop-down list. Now it is important to make sure that you are using the exact network on which you plan to deploy the token. This is the network that is active in your MetaMask interface and is shown here. At the moment, I use the Binance Smart Chain Testnet, but you can choose any other EVM-compatible network, such as Ethereum, Binance Smart Chain, Avalanche, Pulse Chain, Arbitrum, Polygon, and others, simply by switching it in MetaMask. Below you will see the address of the connected wallet and its balance. Make sure it has enough funds for gas spendings. In the drop-down list, select the name of the smart contract we want to deploy. You will need to choose the name you specified earlier, and I have to set CryptoKoki contract. Great, everything is ready to deploy the token. To do this, you need to click the deploy button. If you have done everything correctly, you will be prompted to sign the transaction in MetaMask. After that, a message about successful transaction will appear in the console. And in the deployed contract section, you will be able to see the interface of your token. For now, let's copy its address and check it in the block scanner. And yes, your token has appeared on the blockchain. Today you successfully deployed your first crypto token, but this is just the beginning. In the next lesson, we will look at an important step after token deployment to ensure more trust from investors. Subscribe to the channel to keep up with the latest updates and also go to our website. More products for creating your own cryptocurrency on CryptoKoki.com. Thanks for watching.